And we are back. Now I got some sleep. Interesting. This game technically takes place in the past, but this game was made this year. At least I think it was. Or maybe it was, and maybe it was made like the year it was made, and I don't know. Just this game gets weird. Though again, this one seems relatively. Why is Charles Manson there? Well, I guess it's not really Charles Manson, but you get the idea. But for the most part, this is a normal scene, thank goodness. Two colors. Oh, litmus test, basically, and eyedroppers. I know I saw one, but I already clicked on that one. Very quiet in here, too. Kind of creepy. And there's the other one. Lowest to highest. Yeah, that would be four. This would be seven because it's 21 divided by three. So five, six, seven, eight.
According to the report, this kind of acid has been used for a long time by Russian commandos? Now there's something to worry about. The safe was broken into about 72 hours ago, meaning just after the Abbey's party, which Monty was at.
This one's a little trickier because it's time and. This would be 1 o'clock. It looks like 1 or 2 o'clock. Got it right for a shot.
Blood is Monty's.
No, real. Well, yeah, sometimes it is like a different person's blood. Well, that's not right. That looks. Okay, that's not it.
The prints are Mike's. Nothing bizarre about that. They came from his place.
Yeah.
So the killer is a marksman who might belong to the Russian commandos. This case looks more and more dangerous. but I won't let go that easily. Maybe the Mazakowskis recently sold Russian dolls. It's a lead. I should go see them.
Yeah, I was wondering when we were going to get to the two Russian... Japanese, French, Russian people, because, you know, Russian and Russia seems to be a thing popping up. They redecorated the whole fucking house. Oh no, I think that's their store, actually. I was gonna say, what did they do?
Hello, dear Maya. How do you do?
I'm not sure what the accent is, because it ain't any of the above.
Could be better, thank you.
Are you coming to take advantage of our limited special offer on chapkas?
Tchotchkes, not chapkas. Or maybe I'm going Yiddish, but still.
Not at all. I need information on your Russian doll sales.
The matryochkas? Great choice. They are from $19 to $99, but for you, the price can be reduced to only $89 per half dozen.
What if it's the $19 ones I want a half dozen of? I forget the proper pronunciation of that, but it's clear. This guy is not Russian, but I'm not sure he's Japanese or French either.
Sorry, we misunderstood each other. We just want to know who you sold the dolls to recently.
Are you telling me you are not going to take advantage of such an exceptional offer?
What the fuck is she gonna do with six sets of Russian nesting dolls? Okay, the murderer found a use for probably six sets of Russian nesting dolls, but what the fuck is she gonna do with them?
Unfortunately, yes.
I am too... You know, if there's a fourth game, I want to know what nationality they take, because this is ridiculous. And I kind of wish my husband was here so I could go, okay, what's wrong with this picture? Because I'm looking at stupidity right now.
Well, we just started selling Russian items, and it does not look like we have sold any matryochkas. But who knows? Maybe my wife sold some while I wasn't around.
That's weird. Then where are all these Russian dolls coming from?
She is not here today, but you can check in our accounts book. It should be somewhere there. Help yourselves.
I guess he put two and two together himself and figured, yeah, this is for a murder case, so maybe I should cooperate.
Thank you for your welcome, Mr. Mazakowski.
Doesn't look like they do accents. They just kind of like... I don't know. How do you find any, I guess this is the back, I'm gonna say this is the back room or something.
The key is in this bottle, but it is impossible to get it out through the bottleneck.
I hate that. We had to have gotten in there somehow.
Mr. Mazakowski tells me the key to this drawer has a green ribbon.
Thank you.
Mr. Mazakowski tells me the key to this drawer is very old.
And my brain is telling me this whole game is very weird. Like, okay. Like I said, when I played the first game, I expect this to just be like a very normal little game. Like, you're in a neighborhood, and except for the hidden object scenes themselves, you're, you know, digging through shit, and you are looking for stuff, and you're trying to solve a mystery. In the first game, it was, you know, finding the dog. In the second game, it was finding the, it was the election, or an election mystery, election-based mystery. And the third one would involve a murder of some kind, or at least an attempted murder of some kind, or a threat that would maybe lead into a murder, like in the middle of the game. That's kind of what I was thinking when I picked these up. Half the shit I've seen across all three of these games are things that are making me go, what am I playing? And why? I mean, the first game started out relatively normal. A little goofball with the characters, but okay. You know, haha, a couple of laughs, couple of joking around, da 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 da. Second game, how did I get roped into this? Okay, so we should... Oh, there's the kitty. I knew I saw a cat in here, I just couldn't find it. That was more of an egg than a doll. And I've been to... Well, this game doesn't take place in Russia, thankfully, because I've been to Russia, so I kind of know... I didn't see too many Russian nesting dolls. I think I saw one in my mother-in-law's house and one in a gift shop, and that's about it. They're not that big. I can't even remember how to pronounce the name they actually called. The Matryoshkis? No, I think I just said a Russian family name, but something like that. So they weren't quite saying it right in the game, I know that. My instincts are telling me they're not quite saying it right, but I don't remember how to say it, so I can't even freaking correct them or anything, because... Okay, thank you. I'm not even sure on the tchotchke thing, so... Modern Russian flag, though, so I'm a little surprised. Here it is. Okay. Now we can go into the other thing. Oh, blue buttons. They're very specific. Found the key. Again, this is perfectly normal, just a messy drawer. I'm afraid to go back to the map because it's going to put me in their world. And it's going to start looking normal and then it's going to go into hell. I just know it. Like, you remember, like, the only ones I wasn't like, oh my god, what the fuck, were the sheriff and I think, Oh, I could not see that at all. Well, yeah, I just wanted to finish up in there.
This accounts book hasn't been used much. And obviously there is no trace of a matryoshka sale. Our killer did not buy their dolls from here.
Could have stole them.
All that for nothing. It's not the Mazas who sold the Russian dolls to the killer. I must change course.
Yeah, I'm guessing they're not really suspects because they're not really Russian!
Several indications confirm the professional killer lead, probably Russian. The acid to force the safe, the dolls, the enigmas, everything adds up. To find the murderer, I now need to go another direction. Monty discovered the secret archive on April 3rd, the very same day of the Kingsley party. It's most likely at this party that Monty revealed what he knew and signed his death sentence. But who did he talk to? I must go and hear everything from Abby Kingsley. She has to tell her best friend everything she knows.
Oh, that's taking advantage of things. Oh, we get to see Jason! Yay! Hi, Jason! Let's meet Miss King.
Hi, Abby. Can you tell me about
that
your
is a weird position.
Of course. Setting it up was really funny.
Funny? This kinda looks normal. I mean, Monty's was... It's, like, close to Monty's. Oh no, these are her memories, so they're gonna be a little more normal. Yeah, she doesn't seem like the necktie type. So we'll finish this out and then we will stop for now because it is getting close to time. Seahorse. And scorpion. Yeah, I'm clearing out what isn't, like, blacked out because this way, you know, I'm not, like, looking through everything like an idiot. At least they use the proper term, but I'm pretty sure that's not what they normally look like. Where is that ring? Because I feel like the ring's the last thing I need to, like, start opening things up, too. Oh no, I only need the two things, but still I'd like to find the ring before I, like... Ah, oh, there it is. Or not. Oh, she's actually wearing the ring on her thumb. Okay. Oh, I have the three things. Alright, the pan would probably go... No, so that's a thermostat button.
Abby nearly charred the leg of lamb, and thank God her doggy sweetie smelled something burning and saved the day.
Go, Jason!
Abby is only half listening. I have to help her remember the party exactly.
What goes here? Oh.
Abby tells me her little doggy darling helped her with the cooking and they had a wonderful time.
Dog's like, no, I fucking didn't! Jason's like, no!
Alright, alright. You and Jason had a great time making the food. But the party itself, how did it go?
Oh, a night from hell. To begin with, I had to leave poor doggy in his little kennel. Otherwise, he would have been stomped on. And then, so much got broken.
And, well, we get a little bit of information. Abby's memories aren't so bad either. They're actually kind of nice, comparatively. Wonder what her world's gonna be like. So, this is something I can kind of handle. It's more like a dollhouse, so it being a little disarrayed isn't as freaky to me. But next time we will continue into Abby's memories. And... yeah, she sounds really, like, bummed out she didn't get to have Jason out running around and stuff. I don't blame her. I like having Pete running around when I'm having a party myself. But yeah, it doesn't look like Jason could take a step. So to speak. So, I'll catch you in the next one. Bye!